they're entitled to come back into the country and live here, but that you would monitor them. There are three things that come to mind. Number one, treason, and I know it's very difficult to prove. Number two, seditious conspiracy, which is a little easier, and apparently we've charged some of the guys working with Al-Qaeda with that. And number whatever it is, in terms of revoking their passports, why is there not legislation that we can get passed to do that? And finally, how many FBI agents does it take to track someone 24/7? You say there are 12 of them, although there could be more. And what burden is that creating for you?
Yeah, actually. I think I either garbled it or the way it came across, I think that was a 60 minutes interview, folks misunderstood what I said. Someone with a valid U.S. passport can return to the United States. What I meant to say is we track them very carefully if they're coming back to the United States. If I have evidence that you have fought with any of these foreign terrorist organizations, you will be locked up. We will track you till you land here, then we will lock you up. As you said, there's a variety of, frankly, much easier statutes to use to lock somebody up, if I can prove it. A material support to a terrorist organization is one. So that's fairly easy. I didn't mean, and I'm surprised people thought I meant this, that we will simply follow bad people around the country on whom we have sufficient evidence to prosecute for fighting with ISIL. No. So that's, put that for the rest. So I guess I don't need to answer the rest of it. Folks just misunderstood what I meant. I when someone said to me, I said, people really think I'm an idiot? We're just gonna follow all these people around the country. No. If I have evidence to prosecute you for fighting with a terrorist group, and you have a valid passport, when you land at JFK, you will be at the MCC before the sun goes down.